So far, we have been talking a lot of spiritual related topics or karma or soul. But today I want to actually take you into a very different journey. So we are going to talk about Dr. Edward Bach. So he is a person who is the inventor of the modern inventor of flower remedies or flower essence. So that has actually transformed many people's life, and people are still consuming it, and there's a lot of things happening. And today was his birthday, and he is called the modern father of flower essence. So I think it is worth our time to even know about this person and his great contribution towards mankind. So we'll first go with the history, and I'll also share what is flower remedies and where it is today and how we can utilize this. To start with, I think he was born in 1886 and on the same day today, that is 24th of September. And he belonged to a decent class of family in UK. So in the initial days, he always wanted to become a doctor. The idea of being a doctor in his life was to save people from disease or any other chronic disease he's been suffering. He has been looking at the people around. So what happened is, in the very early age only, he decided he wanted to be a doctor. But his parents couldn't afford to pay for him. So what he did is, he went to the factory where they had their own factory, and he worked there. And during his very early age, when he was working as a factory employee, then he was able to observe the people around him, the workers. They all were like working very hard, and they were trying to keep them fit. The problem is, they were at that time, in during those times in Europe, if you fall sick, it is a very expensive affair. Even today, it is a very expensive affair. So they all were like, if they put a leave, they can't get salary. And if they overwork, their health will get spoiled. And if for the health, they'll have to spend for medicine. So he was able to see the struggle of people in the working class crowd, and then he decided that he have to be a doctor, and he went to a medicine school, and he became a pathologist. And then later he was not satisfied that the method what they were doing, the scientific approach, was not actually healing people. It was only treating the symptoms. They never went a holistic approach there. So he again did surgery later, and he studied surgery. Then he did public health, and a lot of things. He was a pioneer in his field when he was finishing it, and a lot of people used to come to consult with him. And then he was going a little bit deeper into bacteriology, and he did some studies in that, and he saw the pain that comes out of vaccine, the injection based vaccine, and he felt it could not be, and he didn't find it, was happy seeing people injected. So he created bacteria based a lot of vaccines, oral vaccines he created, that is based on other methods also. And it was, even now today, allopathy and homeopathy, they really, some people do recommend those kinds of oral vaccines, what Edward Bach has designed. So then he created that, and again he knows that they are only treating the symptoms. The observation was very simple. He saw that medicines, whatever they were able to at that point of time, allopathy, whatever they had the medicine, it was not curing everyone. He found that certain personality of people, for certain medicine it works, and the same medicine for same symptom, for a different personality, it was not working. So he understood the root cause. So he felt like that there is something gap here, a medicine that is not universal. It is not universal. Every person has to be treated individually. So then he was inspired by the father of homeopathy. So he read his books, and he felt a lot of agreements with him, and that he felt like this is the area where he can go and work on it. So then during that time, he was trying to explore multiple alternative medicines in that time. And he was actually a well-known doctor at that time, and people were coming to him to meet him often for treatment and other things. And suddenly he was, when he was working in a hospital where all the world war people who got hurt and all the soldiers were coming, he was treating them, and suddenly he collapsed in the hospital, and he was undergoing cancer, and they had to remove his spleen, and they had to remove it. And they said he can only live for another 3.5 months maximum. So, but at that time still he was forced to step down from his title of in charge, and he was still taking care of 400 beds of war veterans. So when he was seeing these war soldiers, and he was able to understand their emotional issues, their relationship issues, what these soldiers were undergoing. Today we call this modern post-traumatic stress. Trauma or anything. So in those days it was not termed, but he was able to understand that. And again, his deep inside him, he was trying to figure out why people have to suffer, and is there any simple, there should be some simple remedy. So keeping this homeopathy as his base, and he went back to his countryside, and he spent a lot of time village part of it, the tree, the all other things. So he was able to observe the nature, and he was more of a psychic person. So it is a transformation from modern doctor being scientific and proof and everything. Slowly he was transferring himself into the spiritual world of it. So he was able to sense the plants and trees around him, and he used to be with the plants and trees. So early morning he used to go, and what he used to do is he used to collect the dew drops that is in the flowers, and he used to taste it with his tongue and see what kind of emotional changes it brings in. So then he understood the sun ray, the early morning sun ray has a spiritual meaning, and when the dew drop which is there on the blossoming of the flower, it has that flower's energy in it. So when he takes it, there is some emotional change it was happening in him. So he was experimenting on himself by collecting those dew drops, and he started experimenting, giving it to the people, and there were a lot of miraculous results he noticed it. So initially he created like almost like a 12 remedies, 12 identified flowers he was able to do it. Then later what he did is he can't produce it and more, right? You can't keep collecting dew drops daily. It is a very manual process. There is no automation. So he wanted to try an alternative method. Then he spent more time in a solar method. What he did is he used to collect the flowers in the morning time, put it in the water and keep it in the sunlight for some time, and then he will filter the water and add brandy to it. Brandy is more like a preservative to save that energy of that flower essence in it, and then he would dilute into multiple forms, and then that is called as mother tincture. From the mother tincture he would dilute to the other forms, and he would started recommending it to the people. Okay, so when he was actually doing this with very limited, the 12 first initial combination he got, and he started practicing it, and he never charged people for it, because he felt treating someone medical is their right and nobody has to take money. But the problem is many people who came never came back to him again. They felt like uneasy to do it for free. So then he decided to keep a minimal charge so that they also don't feel awkward to come to him. So then he started exploring various places through his contacts in Italy and other countries. He started telling the methods to them and collect those flower remedies from there, and he was researching. And he even publicly he declared, he was advertising in the newspaper about these remedies, and at that time there the General Medical Council issued a notice on him that they will put him on a case because this is not a scientific method. But he really didn't care, and then he completely left the modern medicinal practice and he entirely devoted his rest of his life into finding out remedies. So what he was trying to understand during that time is, what he realized during that time in his research is that when a soul in a body has a conflict with it, with the body's action, that is, soul want to do something, it has a purpose in the body, and the body is doing something different against the purpose, then there is a disharmony. So when this disharmony happens, there is a change in tissues, growth, certain hormones, it reacts in our mind, and then it reflects in our emotion. So he found out that certain emotions play a very critical role in manifesting various pathological diseases. So what he did is he created a 38 archetype of emotional personalities where those kinds of people need to be treated. So he finally concluded that if you start treating the emotions, automatically the physical symptoms would be solved. Okay, that is the conclusion of his research. And first 12 he was able to do it, and then he created another 19 remedies he created, so total 31. And later he did a lot of research, and he came around to 38. In fact, he created the 12 essential essence, vital essence only. During that time there was a storm in the village, so nearby, and they struggled a lot to rescue a fisherman, and they all felt, the local people felt that this guy would die. But then Dr. Bash, he went there and he took the rescue remedy with him, and he said he gave it to him, and that person was able to sit, and people were like really astonished to see this guy. So he was slowly transforming from a scientist doctor towards a healer to a spiritual person, and then it became very famous, and he completed it 38, and he kept the research, and there is a claim, the official biography, what they say is he has burnt all this research paper and only kept the last 38 is needed for the mankind. But we really don't know what happened there. but there is no documents available, but 38 is what he has left out, and all his research based on what, how he arrived at all these 38, why these flowers, flower essence work on certain emotions, we do not have anything. So they completely, it is destroyed. That's what they claim, he has destroyed it. But he was also a psychic person. So he was able to sense it. Maybe it could be his intuitive answers also from the mother nature. But maybe that part we might not get an answer, but it does work miracle. So based on the emotion, he was able to do it. Now, if you actually come back to India here, now even in India, we have flower essence. Mostly it is not exactly the flower method what homeopathy all they do it. But for thousands of years, Ayurveda, they prepare a lot of kashayams or concoctions, all based not only on the flower, based on the herb, roots, so many things they use it. The Siddha medicine or the Ayurveda, they already have these methods. But Dr. Bhash took it to a very different level. He was able to connect that with psychology and able to connect it with emotion. So the outline of what he understood is, if you start treating the emotion, automatically your body's action will change, your emotions will change, and it will be in sync with your soul. So that is the bottom line, he was able to do it. And even now people are still practicing this 38 combinations, they are using it. Ideally, when you go to a homeopathy doctor or bach flower consultant or any flower essence people, they don't work on you with your symptom. If somebody is telling you, you have a headache, go take this flower essence, means then probably they are not doing it in the right method. They basically allow you to talk, they analyze your character, they see your behavior patterns, they see what kind of emotions you are undergoing, they see your body language. So many things they take into the factor and they will be working on it. For example, if somebody is coming with a severe headache, they'll say, I have a severe headache. They'll observe him. Where does the headache comes from? Is it because he's thinking same thoughts, or is it a repeated thought, or is it coming from a fear, or is it from an anxiety? So then he will address the anxiety related flower remedies, and automatically the headache would go off. That is how they do it. If you ask me, does this alone will solve all the problem? No, because we need to have a proper expert to read people. Reading people and analyzing requires a lot of experience and skill here. Okay, so that is one of the things you will have to be aware of it. And the second point here is, you'll have to look from new changes. At that time, 38 archetype was useful, but then later a lot of new things happened. For example, after him, that's when Pluto came into discovery, and Pluto's influence on human being from an astrological point of view was discovered. Then Uranus, then new planets and stars were being identified at that time. So all those things were added later. So then what happened is that knowledge, and when he reached 50 and he died in the bed, when he was sleeping, and whatever is left over, his assistant Noah, who was his companion all these days during the research. So they took that with her, she took it to a next level, formed a trust, it is an official center right now, and they do even sell it today. A lot of people get certified from them. So then that family itself is owning that, they have it under the trust, and they are maintaining the lineage of Dr. Bhash. So after that, whatever the 38 remedies, whatever they did, it didn't stop there. Many people took his methodologies and work, and they were trying to enhance it with more and more herbs and more remedies. For example, in India, we don't have any of those plants now, okay? But India is full of rich of herbal plants, lot of medicinal value. If you can use that to a different purpose, it is great. So many people took those things. Like in Australia, some healers took it there and they started using the local flowers for similar emotions. They came up with different version. And a lot of other things like aloe vera, tulsi, so many things were now they've converted into essence, and many healers use it in a different form. Okay. So if you see those combination today, there are like almost like identified more than 400 plus flower essence they have identified. Not just flower, there are some exceptions there, like rock water, it is more from a spring water, so they were using it. So it is the point is, what he found out is the archetype and the methodology, and some people still follow the same thing without jumping on it, and some people other side, they have enhanced that with the new needs, with the new, like pandemic, lockdown, so many things are new to us, right? So they are trying to add new things to it, and they are also doing it. It's a continuous evolution process. We should take best of the both. We should not stick, okay, I am only following what he said. He did something, he ran all the way and came to one point and gave it to mankind. And now we can also take it to a next level and give it to it. So what in India many people do it is they use it with other alternative methods or as a complementary method. The way I use it is here is we try to analyze the people through counseling, but other easy method is astrology. When you know about certain planets and how it's there in the chart, we can easily tell them with the current transition what kind of emotions they undergo. So they use now astrology for many doshas which requires a lot of expensive pujas and other things. Bach flower could be another interesting remedies that if it is needed. So to answer the question, and overall if you see if this is alone enough to heal it, no. This is one of the amazing tools that can be utilized, particularly connected to the emotion. But otherwise, this could be another complementary method, you can do it. So that's a short introduction of Bach flower. It's a very big, if I want to talk, I can talk about it for a day. But I hope this gives you an idea and you can take it up and definitely do explore it and learn about it and use it and share your feedback if you have used it and how it is. It might be inspiring many people. And that's all I have for now. And I will meet you in another interesting video. Bye.